Hello students, so we have been discussing chapter number 11, alcohol, phenol and ether. Till now we have discussed IUPAC nomenclature, classification of alcohol, preparation of alcohol and preparation of phenol. Today we are going to discuss new topic, and that is physical properties of alcohol and phenol. Physical properties. Okay. Now, we are writing alcohol like this, ROH, and we are writing phenol like this. Wait, this is phenol, or we can also write phenol like this, AROH. ER means aromatic. So, the physical properties of alcohol and phenol is because of this OH group, right? That means alkyl group and aryl group doesn't play that important role in physical properties. The physical properties of alcohol and phenol is mainly because of this OH group, which means OH groups play an important role for the physical properties. Okay, first physical property is boiling point. Boiling point. Okay, now please remember this topic for all other compounds or for other aldehyde and ketone groups also. So, as carbon number increases, boiling point increases, which means we have got CH3OH methanol, ethanol, propanol. So, boiling point of propanol is more than boiling point of ethanol, and boiling point of ethanol is more than boiling point of methanol, which means that as carbon number increases, boiling point increases. So I am writing BP. BP means boiling point. So as carbon number increases, boiling point increases. Okay, the reason is as carbon number increases, there will be more van der Waals interaction. There will be more van der Waals force. So we can say that compared to methanol, ethanol has got more van der Waals force. Compared to ethanol, propanol has got more van der Waals force. And as van der Waals force increases, boiling point increases. Okay. First point. Second point. Suppose CH3, CH2, CH2. CH2OH, this is butanol. If we write like this, CH3, CH2OH, okay, same number of carbon, same number of hydrogen, right? But here, this is straight chain, here branch has come. So if we compare boiling point of this compound, these are isomers. They have got same molecular formula, but they have got different structure. So if you are asked to comment on boiling point of this compound, boiling point of this butanol will be more compared to this. This is known as 2-methylpropanemanol. So you can ask, sir, why there is difference in boiling point of these compounds? They have got the same molecular formula. The answer is, here state chain is there, but here branch has come, and because of branch, you can see that it has got more surface area, it has got less surface area, and as branch increases, there will be less surface area, and because of less surface area, there will be less van der Waals interaction. So here van der Waals interaction is more. This butanol can have van der Waals interaction with butanol, so more surface area is there. This 2-methylpropanemanol has got less surface area, so it has got less van der Waals interaction. So as we can say that as branch increases, there will be less van der Waals interaction and there will be less boiling point. So branch has got effect on physical properties. Branch increases, boiling point decreases. So first point is, as carbon number increases, boiling point increases, but as branch increases, boiling point decreases. Okay, so this is the main factor. Now, third factor. Third factor is based on hydrogen bonding. Okay. Okay. Now let us understand how hydrogen bond is formed in alcohol. So this is alcohol. Oxygen has got more electronegativity, so negative charge is there. Positive charge is on hydrogen. Another alcohol we can write like this: ROH. Plus charge here, minus charge here. So there will be attraction between oxygen and hydrogen, and that particular attraction is known as hydrogen bond. So there is a hydrogen bond between two alcohol molecules. Same way, if we write phenol like this, so this is phenol, H will be having positive charge, oxygen will be having negative charge, another phenol molecule. Right, we can write like this. So there will be attraction between hydrogen and oxygen. So this is attraction, and that particular attraction is known as hydrogen bond. So there is hydrogen bond between two alcohol or two phenol molecules. So moral of the story is, there is presence of hydrogen bond between two alcohol molecules or between two phenol molecules, or between alcohol and phenol molecules, okay? And because of that, there is difference in boiling point. So if we take same molecular weight compounds like propane, methoxymethane and ethanol, ethanol will have more boiling point. So we are writing like this: CH3CH2OH. This is ethanol. This is methoxymethane. This is ethanol. This is methoxymethane. And third one is propane. So this is propane. Okay. Now these three has got almost same molecular weight. There is not much difference in molecular weight. Molecular weight of ethanol is 46, molecular weight of methoxymethane is 46, and molecular weight of propane is 44. So there is not much difference in case of molecular weight, although they have got different boiling point. The boiling point of propane is 231 Kelvin. The boiling point of methoxymethane is 248 Kelvin. And the boiling point of ethanol is 351 Kelvin. Now you can ask question, sir, if they have got same molecular weight, then why such difference in boiling point is observed? Why is there is difference in boiling point? So the answer is because of hydrogen bond. Ethanol has got more tendency to form hydrogen bond. How this is going to form hydrogen bond like this, okay? Compared to ethanol, propane cannot form hydrogen bond, and there is less tendency to form hydrogen bond for ether. So this is ultimately ether, right? CH3OCH3, that is ether. So ether has got less tendency to form hydrogen bond. Propane cannot at all form hydrogen bond, whereas ethanol can form hydrogen bonds. So please remember this statement for MCQs only. If compound can have tendency to form hydrogen bond, it will have more boiling point. More hydrogen bond, more boiling point. So ethanol has got more tendency to form hydrogen bond, so it is having more boiling point. And the difference in boiling point, look at this. It has got 231 Kelvin and it has got 351 Kelvin. More difference in boiling point, although they have got same molecular weight. So the compound which has got same molecular weight, but there is difference in boiling point because of hydrogen bond only. So hydrogen bond makes difference in case of boiling point. Next physical property is solubility. Okay. So solubility. So next physical property is solubility. Alcohol is soluble in water. The reason is, this is alcohol, it is polar in nature, and water, it is also polar in nature. Oxygen will have negative charge, hydrogen will have positive charge, and there is hydrogen bond between alcohol and water. And because of this hydrogen bond, alcohol is soluble in water. But as carbon number increases, as alkyl chain increases, there will be less solubility of alcohol in water. Which means that if we compare methanol, ethanol, and propanol in terms of solubility, methanol will have higher solubility compared to ethanol, and ethanol will have higher solubility compared to propanol. The reason is, they all can form hydrogen bond, right? So alcohol is soluble in water, but it has got one carbon only, it has got two carbon, it has got three carbon. As carbon number increases, as alkyl chain increases, there will be more non-polar group. So this is non-polar group. So non-polar chain is getting increased, and our solvent water is polar. So as non-polar group is increased, as the chain increases, the solubility decreases. So in general, alcohol is soluble in water, but as carbon number increases, or we can say that alkyl chain increases, solubility will decrease. So alcohol is soluble in water, but as carbon number increases, solubility will decrease.